Welcome back to the channel, guys. I hope you're having a great weekend. Just want to get into another video with you, talk about a few projects, SparkPoint, Plair, ShareRing, and so on. And I must say, SparkPoint definitely hasn't disappointed, okay? Going into this weekend, I expect this to continue up over the weekend. Normally when I see a coin like this start popping off after the evening hours of the weekend, I do expect them to go up consistently over the weekends and hopefully into the next week. But you know, you could see a sell-off before the end of that, but there's nothing to worry about with a project like this, especially now it's breaking into DeFi, SparkPoint that is. And I mean, when it comes to projects taking off in this sort of manner, we're on the 1 day chart now, and obviously you can see SparkPoint has gone up significantly. Roughly my entry was around that point, so we're up about 205%. You can see the candles are continuing to the upside, so I'd like to see that continue. We reached a local top, a local high, and you can see we're currently in price discovery on SparkPoint. Okay, so that's good. And yeah, price discovery, new all-time high, and hopefully we can see that continue to the upside. If you can compare it with the likes of ShareRing, where you see it broke, it made a high over here, and then it broke through that and retested and carried on up, made a new all-time high, and now it's still in price discovery. It's still trying to make all-time highs. And now if we compare the level from where it broke out of the previous high that it made, we can see that that actually has gone up roughly another 311%. But at the same time, it's currently around the 5 cent mark, ShareRing is now. And it does seem to be losing a bit of strength in regards to a push to the upside. But with a new exchange coming next week with Bithum, and the logic to me is there's only one T after, it's BITHUM, and someone's, you know, some people say it's Bithum, I'm saying Bithum, it doesn't really matter, we know what I'm talking about. But yeah, with ShareRing being listed on Bithum next week, starting from the 3rd, which is Monday, we could see a huge spike in volume coming through, or we could see a big sell-off as it gets onto the exchange, buy the rumor, sell the news type of thing. And then you can see probably maybe a continuation to the upside after that, after a little cool-off period. But ShareRing definitely hasn't disappointed and is definitely making waves in the crypto space. I'm not sure why a lot more people aren't talking about ShareRing at the moment, because it's definitely one to talk about right now, in my opinion. It's definitely holding these levels pretty well. But, and you know, we can see like a short sell, I've got bought back up over here. We can see the long wick reverses to the upside. That's looking all right. The volume is dropping off, but it could pick back up pretty soon, especially in the next week. So yeah, that's one to watch. Like I say, SparkPoint definitely doesn't disappoint, and I'm looking for big things for SparkPoint. And SparkPoint is still very cheap, guys. It's still not even 1/10 of a penny at the moment, and you know, I can see this getting to over a penny soon, actually, especially with the DeFi side of things kicking in now. Plair is struggling to break up, but it is in a better position than what it was yesterday. I wonder whether we could see this curve continue. Let's have a look. Where am I looking? Okay, I don't know where my curve tool is on this, because I've never used it, to be honest, on BitMart. But Where's my curved line? This is the thing. So before I discovered some of these hidden gems, I wasn't really using BitMart. The reason why I started using BitMart is because I discovered sharing on BitMart. Alright, I'm going to show you how I discovered it in a minute, alright? Let's just go back to Plair for a moment. So Plair looks like it's curving to the upside. Will we see a parabolic curve with Plair? Could be a small cup and handle there. You know, who knows? We'll have to wait and find out. It doesn't seem to be finding much strength to be able to break out of these levels. As we can see, we saw the market buy all the way up to 250 over there. It tried to climb back up, found some temporary resistance around this level right over here, and failed to break through that level, got rejected, coming back down. And is it going to retest it? If it does, it's probably going to break through that level, and you'll see, you know, some consolidation around here and a continuation to the upside. But if it doesn't, then we could see it coming back down. But the pattern that's forming is like a U-shaped curve, so it does look like it's uptrending to the upside. So it's one that you just have to wait and see how it plays out, to be honest. So let's draw a line like that and see whether that can hold over the next couple of days and weeks. All right, but how do I find? Okay, so I'll show you how I found sharing, right? So when you're on a low liquidity exchange like BitMart, all right, there's a lot of coins you can see on here, you know, quite a lot of coins, ones that a lot of people haven't particularly heard of, maybe. You've got your XRPs, your EOS, your Chainlink, and whatever, but it's not the exchange that you really want to be buying them on, because the liquidity is low and it might not be easy to get an order filled. So it's definitely not the go-to when you're looking at you know, high liquidity performers like Link and XRP, and you know, you can definitely, you know, be making better trades and better entries and exits on a higher tier exchange like Binance or Kucoin or even Coinbase, for example. Okay, now if you look through, like, what you can do is you can scroll through and sometimes you can see coins that are popping off. Okay, that's SRK is at 32%. Hex is, you know, I don't like Hex. That's, people say it's a scam, you know, I definitely got some. Okay, so you can see something like this where it's 53% down. All right, double digit red day on LPK, whatever that is. All right, so when I go on the chart and I look, I see how illiquid this chart is. Yeah, it's not even a consideration for me as a buy. All right, all this choppy action, it doesn't tell the same story as something like SRK, where you can see it's, you know, it's got clear, you know, liquid in the chart, and it's not just not all this slippage. All right, and if you look at, I mean, this one's got some, okay, 2 million. Let's see how much 2 million is worth right now on here. 2,117,000 if you was to buy. $302. Okay, so what I'm using here is a Cryptonator, which is a cryptocurrency calculator and converter. I use this a lot just to find out, because, like, especially on BitMart, it might show the last recorded price that your portfolio is sitting at overall, but it doesn't show the current sometimes. So it's good to kind of like calculate how much it is if you were to sell at that point in BTC, bring it over to the calculator, and it can give you an accurate estimation of what your current holdings are at. So I use that a lot of the time. All right, but let's just have a look. Okay, so sometimes, look, you can see this FDZ or Z, however you pronounce it. Liquidity is not there, very illiquid, lots of slippage, and it doesn't look like anything that I would even bother putting my hard-earned money in. In a coin like this, you can see it go all the way up there, but then there'll be no buy order down here. So it'd be hard for you to get out. All right, so it's all good watching your money go up and down, but if you can't sell it, you've not really realized those profits. Okay, you can see something like this XSR, which is up 170%. Now, why is it up 170%? I mean, a small injection of money can bring that to the upside, especially if the market cap is low. So what you really want to be looking for is, if you go on sharing, what you want to be looking for is you want to see that volume accumulating. Okay, so if you can see this chart from the beginning, you can see the price action has been very clear, and you know, it tells a nice story on the chart, and you can see the volume picking up, you can see all the accumulation, you can see it come up and down, the potential double bottom kind of, you can see all this volume picking up over here, and this volume and accumulation build up is a sign of things to come. Obviously you can see it push up to the upside. It might look like a small push on the chart there, but if you have a look, you'll see from here to here we're looking at 300-400%. So that's not a small move at all, guys, but as the moves gets bigger, the previous moves look smaller. Okay, so then you see from there it comes down again, and then it pops off another 600-700%. Okay, so obviously you can see all that accumulation build up, and that continues through there, and we see the price explosion now into price discovery. Okay guys, so that's really all I've got for you today. If you haven't subscribed already, you know what to do. Like, comment, and I guess I'll see you again in the next video.